A KPI, which stands for Key Performance Indicator, is a measurable value that can help managers and employees evaluate key business objectives. To create a useful KPI, you must identify the measures that tell you something relevant about a known business objective. Some indicators only show you how you've performed, that is, they show you a result that has already happened. We call these lagging indicators. A classic example of lagging indicators are financial metrics, such as total purchase value. A lagging indicator reveals past or current performance, which is important for understanding business objectives, but not helpful for predicting future performance. The most useful indicators expose something about a business objective that can be acted upon. That is, they tell you something about future results. We call these leading indicators. A good example of a leading indicator might be employee satisfaction ratio. High or low employee satisfaction might affect business objectives like innovation and employee engagement, and a business can take actions based on this indicator. Both leading and lagging KPIs are important, and a business will benefit from using a good balance of both. Lagging indicators to monitor current performance and leading indicators to correct and drive performance. When creating KPIs, it is good to follow some of the KPI best practices. Choose KPIs that align with the strategic goals and business objectives of your organization. Build KPIs from data that is obtainable in your organization. Share KPIs so everyone in your organization is on the same page and moving in the same direction. Use data that is reliable and accurate. KPIs should evolve with the business. Here are a few examples that show KPIs that are useful for different teams. A sales team might use KPIs to track their sales team objectives, such as sales variation, margin variation, and sales versus the sales goal. A customer support team might use KPIs to monitor the overall case duration, the average case duration, and the number of closed cases. Those are just a few examples of how you can use KPIs for different business cases. Now, to learn how to make KPIs with Qlik, take a look at this video.